thanks so much for joining us today on Playing the Field. I'm Maria Sorreo. We are here today at Peninsula High School, where you will meet the varsity boys basketball team. Now, this team has been doing very well. They've won their last 11 of 13 games, including their biggest rival, Palos Verdes.
Our preseason schedule, we schedule competitive games to prepare us for league. So the first tournament we played in was the Redondo Pac Shores, which always has the top teams from Southern California. We played three top competitive games against Rancho Christian, Santa Margarita, and Harvard Westlake, who are really top in their division. So since those three losses, we're 14-4. We won, like you said, 11 out of 13. We're 4-1 in the Bay League play. So after the first round, we're in sole possession of second place. So I couldn't be more pleased where we are right now.
That they learned the most from a loss that really kind of propels them to say, we're going to be in the winning column now?
Well, it's weird. Sometimes in the post game, I tell the kids that they play better in losses than they do with wins, and they can work off of that. Because when you're playing those top teams who have Division I players and you're playing with them, it tells us that we can play with anybody. And if you do that night in and night out, you're going to be competitive each night.
What do you think that from this season that most of these guys have learned this year?
Play together as a team. I think in the summer and the fall, guys were trying to go more one-on-one while they were learning the offense. I think when they broke down, they just tried to go and make something quick when it wasn't there. But as time went on, practicing every day, the guys are feeling more comfortable with each other. We're moving the ball so well. We find the open man. There's been games this year where four or five guys are scoring double figures, and that's the testament to their hard work.
You know, interesting, because it seems like when players are playing as a team and they start to trust, this goes from all the way from grade school, I think, to the pros. That's when you see the success. Why?
With this group, they've known each other since elementary school, like you said. A lot of high school nowadays, kids are coming in from all over, transfers and all that. But this is a real community school. They went to elementary, middle school, high school together. So they want to play for each other and their school and their community. And when you come to home games, alumni come back. Parents of alumni still come and watch us play. It's a true community feel. And when you have that, kids are going to play harder.
You're doing very well this year in basketball. This team is doing very well. What's been the biggest difference, do you think, this season?
I think we've really come together as a team and through team bonding, and we've really pushed each other in practice every day.
You play multiple sports. How difficult is it to transition from one to another one?
It's not too bad. Each sport kind of helps you train for the other one. I mean, there's things like shooting and throwing that are different, but you work through them.
I know that a lot of you guys are close. You've known each other for a long time. What do you think are the biggest challenges that you guys are sort of working through to get to the next level?
Just continuing to fix the mistakes in practice and continue to push each other and get better.
Okay. So big win against PV. Tell us a little bit about that game last night.
It was crazy. Both the Red Tide and the Zoo were awesome. A lot of energy. It was fun.
It started last year, last March in the offseason. We had a couple great tournaments over the Christmas break, and we just built a lot of team chemistry over that course of time and really put it together.
All right. What do you, why did you choose basketball as your sport?
I actually played soccer for 10 years, and I had to make a really tough decision in eighth grade. But I was getting a little worn out with soccer, and basketball came along in like seventh and eighth grade. So I kind of decided to pick that and kind of stuck with it.
Why do you think you stuck with this?
It was something new. I kind of knew what to expect with soccer, and basketball was just kind of in that kind of mysterious kind of part of the life for me. So I decided to stick with it.
A different kind of a challenge?
Differently, totally.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. When you guys are moving forward now, you're playing well. 11 out of 13 is pretty awesome. What do you think the biggest challenges for the team are moving forward now?
Taking it one game at a time. I think that's key. Obviously, we look ahead to that next PV game, because last night was awesome.
Yeah.
But we have four really good teams ahead of us, and we got to take it, day by day.
Is it helpful to beat APV and give you that added shot in the arm to move forward?
Yeah, it's a huge confidence boost for us. But we still have to stay hungry, come ready to work every day.
I think we just come into practice every day and we really work hard. We play as a family and we're really unselfish. So I think that's kind of what's changed from last year's. We're more unified as a team.
Do you think that's like an ongoing process of learning, or how does that work?
Yeah, well, I think we've all been really good friends since we were little, and we've all been playing together since like the early days, so that's how we've kind of come together this year.
I wanted to ask you how long you've been playing, why you chose basketball.
Oh, I've been playing forever, like for as long as I can remember. And I chose it because like I really didn't like wearing long pants in baseball, and then soccer was a little too dirty, so I just like basketball.
Okay. And then tell me, in addition to what you've learned, what's been the biggest challenge this year?
For me personally, I think it's been my shot. I've been changing my shot recently, and it's all coming together for me right now.
I played it ever since a young age. I probably started playing when I was like 6 or 7, and I started playing at the local YMCA.
And did you play any other sports, or did you just stick with this one?
I used to play soccer, and I think I used to play flag football too.
So is this the one you focus in on, or do you still play all the other ones?
This is the main one I focus in on. I stopped playing football and I gave up on soccer.
Okay. This has been quite an amazing season for you guys. A lot of the guys talking about how you've known each other for a long time and you're bonding. Where do you think that's from?
I don't know. I think it's just because like we like to hang out after school. The chemistry is good. We're always talking to each other, messing around.
Are together even off the court?
Yeah, we hang out a lot. We're close.
I chose basketball because when I was 3 years old, my dad introduced me to the game, and once he showed me the game, I just fell in love ever since.
You guys are on a very good run here. I know a lot of you have played together for a long time, and just sort of tell me about the dynamic of that and playing with these guys this year.
Well, I mean, from previous years, I feel like the chemistry was never as good. Like, but this year, the team, we're just a lot more closer. And like, we took a trip to San Luis Obispo and spent a lot of time together. And we have grown almost as like a family. I mean, we are a family, so.
You guys had a very big win in PV. What kind of confidence does that sort of add to your game?
It's the whole year for us, honestly. I mean, that's the game we look forward to the most. I mean, I know all the other teams that we play are really good, but it's just PV. That's the one that we want to get. Like, we have to win when we play them.
Do you feel like it sort of launches you for the rest of the season?
Oh, definitely. I mean, and then because then we end the season playing them too, so it's just like going into playoffs, we get that extra boost again.
I actually played baseball, soccer, and basketball up till I was 5th grade. Then I quit baseball, and then I played soccer until I was in 7th grade, and I actually grew tired of soccer. And I just realized that every time I went to a soccer game, I would just want to be playing basketball. So I just realized my passion was in basketball, so I decided to quit soccer, and I stayed with basketball I played on the 7th and 8th grade team, and then all of high school.
Difficult to go from one sport to another, or do you kind of take everything you learn from that into this now?
Yeah, I mean, it is definitely a transition from one sport to another, but in both sports, I'm the kind of guy that just works hard and hustles, goes all over the court or the field, so it wasn't too bad of a transition. Both of them, I just worked hard, and here I am, basically, yeah.
So this team doing very well at the right time, peaking at the right time. Tell me about this team this year and what makes it a little bit different, maybe.
Well, this year especially, I'm playing with players that I've been playing basketball with since I was basically in elementary school and throughout middle school and then high school. I've been playing with these guys for so long that the chemistry already developed. And we went to a San Luis Obispo tournament, and that definitely got us closer as a team. We stayed in the same hotel rooms. We each got a teammate to stay in the same room as, and it brought us closer while we were playing basketball. So that was great.
Seems like, you know, you try to build trust over the years, and now you guys completely have that.
Yeah, definitely. We definitely have trust in each other. We are willing to give each other the ball, share the ball around, and then take the right shot, yeah.
I have to ask, because you beat PV, how much of a shot in the arm is that for you guys?
That was the most, the craziest game I've ever played. That was the most fun game. We were all super hyped. That was an awesome game to win, especially for this team, yeah.
We have great teamwork. we work together very well. We're very positive. We help each other out, and that's just how it is.
Okay. This year specifically, especially the last 11 of 13 games you guys have won, so much about basketball is trust. And it seems like you guys have really kind of figured that out.
It develops. Like in the beginning, obviously we're not very familiar with each other and how we play, but as we go along in the season, it gets better. We trust each other more. Chemistry gets stronger.
Why did you choose basketball as your sport, and how long have you been playing?
I've been playing since fifth grade summer into sixth grade. I chose basketball because I met a very inspirational man. His name is Russell Payne. He coached me ever since then. I played for him for like 6 years.
And why was he so inspirational to your basketball career?
When I began, I wasn't very athletic, wasn't very motivated, and he was a very motivational coach. He pushed us very hard. He pushed me very hard, and he taught me a lot of things, not only on the court but outside, with life too.
Always nice to get to recognize somebody like that in your life for sure. Tell me what you think your biggest challenges are now moving forward.
My biggest challenges will be stepping up next year when a lot of seniors will be gone, so I'm gonna need to work on my game over summer. Need to help support the team a lot more next year.
I've been playing basketball for about 6-7 years, and I chose it because a lot of my friends played it, and I really wanted to play it.
Okay. This has been a very good season for you guys so far. What do you think has been the reason for that?
This group is something special. We practice all the time. It's something different that no other team I've ever been on.
Like it's been sort of building over time, or
yeah, we've seen each other before, and we've played with each other before, and it's just been so fun.
Okay. Big win last night against PV. Obviously, tell me a little bit about that game.
It was probably the most crowded game I've ever been to, and I didn't play much, but I mean it was just something that I will always remember.
Well, I mean, everyone's like working as a group. We have like insane chemistry. We're all friends. We've all bonded over a long time, and yeah. You
know, everybody's sort of mentioning that about the bonding and knowing each other. And I know trust is such a huge factor when you play basketball. When did you feel like that really changed?
You know, like we've always had that. Like we've always had that. It's just always been like that.
And why did you choose basketball as your sport, and how long have you been playing?
I've been playing like most of my life. Yeah, I've chosen it because, you know, I just think that's what I'm best at, and it's just super fun for me.
Okay. All right, and what do you think the biggest challenges are from here on out?
Here on out, like, we battled through a lot of injuries, and mainly just working as a group and, like, getting everything going the right way.
I just think this team is like, we're all friends, not just on the basketball court, also outside of school, so that helps a lot. Just great bonding team, and that helps on the court.
Why did you choose basketball as a sport you wanted to play?
Basketball's super exciting, and especially with the crowd here at this school, it makes it even better.
What do you think that I know from year to year you learn different things. What do you think you've learned the most this year?
This year is just like playing together as a team. I've had like years where it's kind of like the team doesn't work well together, but this year everyone's working really well, and it's helped us a lot.
And what do you think's the biggest challenge as you, you know, near the end of the season?
Just staying focused game to game and coming out with the right energy every single game.
Well, start off with the coaches pushing us every day at practice, and just us as a team, we're just so close and we always push each other during practice just to get better every day.
You know, I know it's next man up, but when one of your guys went down, you guys accelerated that. Is that just something you got together and said, hey, we got to make this happen? Or?
Yeah, that was basically a team effort thing. Us as a team, we're all brothers, so when one brother falls, you know, we got to play for him. He's with us every day.
Okay, why did you choose basketball as your sport, or do you play other sports too?
I chose basketball as one of my sports. I enjoyed it as a kid growing up, and I really just wanted to play it.
Is it difficult to adjust to going from one physical sport to a different kind of physical sport?
There's definitely a learning curve there with football, and when you play that for 6-7 months, it's really hard to come back into basketball and be ready. But it probably took me about a month to really get back into basketball shape, which was a real test of my strength and character, but, you know, besides that, it was pretty good.
You guys are doing really well, you know, in this season. What do you think that is attributed to?
I think we have a really close group of guys here. Obviously, it was really bad for our team when Jordan went out with his concussion, but we all kind of rally around him now, and we I think that's a sentiment to everyone on our team, being able to come through and step up, really, and we're just a really close group of guys. And
interesting that you say that, because when somebody does go down, it's next man up, but you really have to bond together, and like you mentioned, you guys have known each other for a long time. Is it easier to play when you have that trust going on?
Yeah, I've been playing with some of these guys on this team since like fifth or sixth grade, so we really have a strong connection. There's definitely a lot of camaraderie that goes on off the court as well, and we had a trip down to Cal Poly SLO, and I think after that we really became a close-knit group of guys and we were ready to play.
I was going to ask you why you chose basketball, but you've chosen a lot of different sports to play. Why basketball?
Basketball was my first love. Both my brothers played, and I always watched them play, and I thought it was really fun and interesting, and then my dad always wanted me to play, so I guess that's why, yeah.
I've been playing basketball since I was in fifth grade. And I chose to play that sport because my whole family played. And I've been playing at the YMCA with Dom and like all my other like teammates that I'm playing with right now. So like we got a good chemistry going, and yeah.
It seems like all the guys that I'm talking to are saying that the chemistry is so good. Is that easier to trust? Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, it's easier to trust my teammates when they're open and I'm passing them the ball, because I know what they can do, and yeah.
Okay, and then big win last night, beating PV. Tell me what that was like.
Yeah, I picked up two fouls in the first half. I picked up two fouls, but like second half I came back in, because after those two fouls I didn't play the first half, so I came in the second half. I started moving the ball, getting shots, getting open shots, and some of my shots like fall.
So,
yeah.
Why did you choose basketball as your sport?
Because I would have basketball.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. What pro teams do you like, and which players do you enjoy watching?
My favorite teams are the Cavs and the Lakers. I like watching LeBron James and Nick Young.
Favorite NBA team is the Indiana Pacers, and my favorite NBA basketball player is Klay Thompson.
I like the Clippers, they're my favorite team, and my favorite player is Chris Paul.
I'd have to say right now the Lakers, and I like watching Brandon Ingram on the Lakers. He's probably my favorite.
Favorite team, I'd say the Cavs. Cleveland Cavaliers, my favorite player, because my favorite player is Kyrie Irving.
My favorite team is OKC Thunder. My favorite player is Russell Westbrook.
My favorite NBA team is probably the Los Angeles Clippers. And I love watching them. I just love watching Chris Paul, Blake Griffin, DeAndre Jordan all together.
My favorite team is the Lakers. And I love watching Kobe, but he's gone now.
I'll have to go with the Lakers. They're not doing too well, but I mean, yeah, they're young. Some players I like to watch. I love watching like LeBron, Steph Curry, and Kevin Durant.
My favorite team is the Clippers, and I really like watching Damian Lillard play.
I am a Los Angeles Lakers fan, and I guess I like watching D'Angelo Russell.
I don't really have a favorite pro team, but my favorite player, well, since Kobe's out, is Kevin Durant now. So yeah,
I like Stephen Curry.
Okay.
Yeah.
My favorite pro team has to be the Lakers. I love watching them, and if I had to say who I love to watch, probably Kevin Durant or Steph Curry.
Well, I think the one thing that we've learned is we all like to watch Steph Curry, but we are Laker and Clipper fans for life. Thanks so much to the boys varsity basketball team here at Peninsula for spending some time with us. I'm Maria Serrao, and we'll see you guys next time.